Cleaned up for delicate American years, Diaosi means unprivileged loser. It refers to young people who don't have a relative who can help them land a job in the bureaucracy or a state-owned company. Not only are those jobs secure and well-paid, they can also lead to other perks like housing and even bring bribes. Diaosi began as a pejorative term for fans of Li Yi, a mediocre but relentlessly self-promoting soccer player. Akin to soccer hooligans, a typical Diaosi loser wallows in self-pity and self-mockery. Born after 1980 when China started its economic reforms, they are trapped in dead-end jobs and exist on paltry wages. They are often migrant workers, street peddlers, or day laborers living semi-legally in China's big cities. They hang out in dingy internet cafes playing video games or looking at porn. But something's changed. Countless white-collar workers, IT professionals, and clerks are now calling themselves Diaosi. Even Han Han, a race car driver, successful author, and online celebrity, claims to be one. He boasted to his 10 million followers on Weibo that he was an authentic Diaosi from the rural outskirts of Shanghai who started from scratch with no power or connections. Yiguan.cn, an IT market analyst, estimates that almost 600 million Chinese think of themselves as losers. They resent China's privileged class, those whose success reflects their political pedigrees and their links to powerful officials, not their hard work or talent. The group is known as the Red Aristocracy. Moreover, resentment of today's Diaosi comes as much from insecurity and frustration as from lack of money. For example, 52% of them own their own homes, but the rising cost of living, static incomes, uncertain legal rights, and a ragged social safety net makes life a perennial struggle marked by uncertainty. Further, they breathe polluted air, drink dirty water, and eat unsafe food, but they believe the Red Aristocracy gets its air and water carefully filtered and its food supplied from special organic farms. Many can afford to emigrate or send their families abroad. China has no real middle class. It is only high-end Diaosi class. Li Chengpeng, a writer and social commentator, wrote on Sina Weibo. A recent editorial in the Communist Party's People's Daily criticized the Diaosi as lazy non-achievers. It drew comments like these on Sina Weibo, the Chinese Twitter. Baby formula is poisoned by you guys. Rivers stink horribly. The air is filled with apocalyptic despair. Housing prices rise faster than anything else. Now you tell me to stop being lazy. I'm damn fortunate just to be alive. That post was shared more than 277,000 times. The middle class was supposed to bring stability to China, but maybe not. In the past few years, so many large-scale protests were staged successfully by the middle class concerned about issues like health, education, and property values. Since it opened up, the government has lifted hundreds of millions out of poverty. But China's younger are asking, "What have you done for me lately?" For Link Asia, I'm Jing Gao.
Airwaves, a global channel of uncompromising stories, world news, documentaries, entertainment, and culture. Link TV, connecting you to the world. For more information, visit linktv.org.